I killed my father. Killed him with venom that had gained in potency through years of patient waiting. A snake that had used all the cunning of its kind to get past the complex shield of defenses. My father, who had been warned of the conspiracy by his secret police well ahead of time, had surrounded himself with a palace. A palace perched atop a single column that stood like a crystal lotus on a steel stem in the middle of a vast lake, patrolled round the clock by crocodiles, and which he thought was not for this assassin too.
Why is Janamejaya exploding in rage? Let's rewind back to Parikshit. Parikshit, Janamejaya's father. What an idiot he was. You don't believe me? Watch. Our great Parikshit is hunting in the forest. He aims at a stag. Misses. Wait. He has found something. Someone. An old rishi meditating under a tree.
Tattum. Tattum.
The rishi cannot hear you. He cannot see you. The rishi is in a state of deep trance. What's the idiot doing now? Oh my God! He has found a dead snake crawling with insects. I don't believe this. He has thrown the dead snake around the rishi's neck. With a king like this, do we need a clown? The rishi's son comes rushing in and curses Parikshit. Within 13 days, you will be killed by a snake. You will be killed by Serpent King Takshaka. So what does Parikshit do, huh? Why? He locks himself into an impenetrable fort. Meanwhile, Serpent King Takshaka is wondering just how to get past top security, fulfill the curse, and take his own personal revenge in the bargain. On the 13th and final day, Takshaka finds a way. He calls all his Naga people together, asks them all to disguise themselves as holy men. The best disguise ever. Don't we know? And they carry a fruit basket to Parikshit as a blessing, as an offering. The sun is setting. Parikshit believes the day is done and he is free of the curse. Is he? Watch.
Timah, my. सुहृदश्चैव प्रो
तापसै रूपजीतानि फलानि सहितामय
from above and do a little jig in the night sky.
ता हमपि तं पापं गमृतः रिक्तुं तर्गतं तद्दुभिश्च
ಚಾಮಿ ಪನ್ನಗಂ ಪಥಾಮ ಪಂಪಾಪಂ ದತ್ತು ಬಿಚ್ಚಾಮಿ ಪನ್ನಗಂ ದತ್ತು ಬಿಚ್ಚಾಮಿ ಪನ್ನಗಂ ದತ್ತು ಬಿಚ್ಚಾಮಿ ಪನ್ನಗಂ.
I knew nothing of all this at that time. I was only a child then. My guardians had to wait patiently for me to come of age to lay this terrible piece of knowledge on me. But now that I know, I assure the slippery sons of Kadru, they will not get away with it. My vengeance will be swift and terrible. I will not rest until I have exterminated them all. They will discover that no hole is deep enough to hide from Janavijaya.
What would your reaction be? What would your reaction be if someone were to come up to you and say, my father died of snake bite? When? Oh, I was too young then, I don't even remember. But I am going to avenge his death by killing every single snake that lives. Yes, by wiping out the whole species from the face of the earth. You would naturally assume the man is joking. And after you realize he's not, he's completely serious, you may look at him closely perhaps, trying to remember the name of a good shrink. Or try to explain to him your own plan. Your own plan to cleanse the earth of all ants. Because one bit your mom. Or try to explain to him how morally unjustifiable his position is, how politically incorrect. And if the person voicing such sentiments should happen to be the king of a sizable country, it should be cause for concern indeed for the future of the country in question. One might decide to do something about it.
Somasya yajnyo varunasya yajnya prajapater yajnya asita yoge.
But what do the people around Janamejaya do? They applaud and encourage him.
Yamasya yajnyo harimedhasascha yatha yajnyoranti devasya rajnya.
All the great sages invent a yajna just for his convenience.
Krishnasya yajna satyavatya svatasya svayam cha karma prajakara yatra.
A question of national importance would now seem to be, who will bag the contract for constructing the sacrificial township?
Vidhivara yajna yatana bhira
great rishis and maharishis, so-called great thinkers, the finest minds of our age, even people like Atreya, Uddalaka, Shvetaketu, people we thought of until, oh, the day before yesterday, as living volcanoes of conscience, ready to blow their tops at the first sign of wrongdoing in the land, seem strangely silent and worried about just one thing: how to wangle a job for themselves as officiating priests. Besides, it's not every day that the king himself comes to you with a blank check and all but begs you on bended knees to accept the offer. How can anyone refuse? When you realize that even someone like the great Vyasa himself looks upon the event essentially as a not-to-be-missed opportunity to unleash his self-indulgent epic upon an unsuspecting world. Way too long, if you ask me, 204,000 verses? The Lord have mercy. What it badly needs is a good editor. Besides, what do you think of an old man who saw it as no part of his business to interfere, let alone stop the madness of his grandchildren from getting completely out of hand, who let it run its full course to the inevitable tragic ending, saw them all kill each other off, just stood by as a whole nation destroyed itself. And instead of being ashamed of the whole saga and his own role in it, or trying to forget it all, quietly set out to put down the whole wretched chronicle in black and white and in polished verse, to the eternal shame of posterity.
Janavijayasya Rajashri Sarvasatre Mahatmana Krishna Dvaipayana Prota Sukunya Vividha Kata Kathitascha Vidhivadya Vaishampayane Namahi Vaishampayane Namahi Shrutvaham Tavya Chitratha Mahabharata Samshruta.
Krishna Dvaipayanar Yendra Veda Vyasar Yetriya Dharmamum Shantiyum Paripurnamahaniraindha Mahabharata Kadai Adharmame Uruvana Akramame Nilayana Sarvanasha Sarpayagatil Vedavyasarin Prathama Sishyarana Vaishampayana Munivaral Odappadugirad.
What she's saying is simply this: Mahabharata, the great epic of Dharma, was first narrated during the ritual of Adharma, the snake sacrifice by that man over there, Vaishampayana, the disciple of Vedavyasa.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namah Pitamahaya. Om Namah Prajapatebhyaha. Om Namah Krishna Dvaipayanaya. Om Namah Sarva Vigna Vinayakebhyaha.
And why did the Serpent King Takshaka want to kill Parikshit?
This is a very tricky question. It's a very important question, and the question around which our whole story revolves. So I am going to try and explain it as best I can, as clearly as I can, and I really want you to pay attention. Don't ask me again. Why? And that goes for all of you. You miss it now, you miss it all. And why did Takshaka, the Serpent King, want to kill Parikshit? Because Parikshit's grandfather Arjuna, Janamejaya's great-grandfather Arjuna, same guy. Well, when Parikshit's grandfather Arjuna destroyed the Khandava forest, Takshaka's kingdom, killed Takshaka's wife, and all his Naga people along with it.
Did Arjuna destroy the Khandava forest all by himself?
No. He had expert help from fire god Agni and best friend Krishna.
How did they do it?
Well, one day, Arjuna and Krishna went to the Khandava forest. A fun trip, a jolly picnic. They roamed in the woods, played under the trees, swam in the wild river. And when these two Mahatmas had enough, Vyasa calls Arjuna and Krishna Mahatma, great soul. When these two Mahatmas had enough, they sat under a Maha tree and had a Maha chat.
About what?
What do Mahatmas talk about? Great souls talk about great deeds. And these two great souls talked about their great deeds. Great deeds of maiming, killing, defeating, destroying, decimating people. That's when fire god Agni appeared before them and said, "Oh, great Mahatmas, do another great deed for me today. I want to gobble up the Khandava forest, reduce Takshaka's kingdom to cinders. But every time I try to burn this forest, Indra, king of the heavens, sends floods of rains down and puts my flames out. But today, you are here with me. I will give you divine weapons. Divine weapons. Test them out. Come on, help me."
Nisa, 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 Nis
Where life was allowed to express itself.